Hey everyone, welcome to the Daniel M. Sarf Planetarium. Bob Onador here. We're going to explore the galaxy's ultimate dependent relationship. We're talking connections between the Sun and the Earth. Our Sun is only one of billions of stars in the galaxy, but it still dominates everything in the solar system. Okay, compared to us tiny humans, the Earth is huge. It's 8,000 miles across. Bigger than Venus, Mars, Mercury, four times bigger than our moon. But our Earth is a shrimp compared to our big boss Sun. Over a million Earths could fit inside the Sun. Heck, over 1,000 Earths could fit inside Jupiter. We are dependent on the Sun. Its massive hot nuclear furnace provides us with the necessary light, heat, and energy. Without the Sun, we'd be a cold ball orbiting, who knows, Jupiter. Despite the Sun's dominance and overbearing presence, we are attracted to the Sun physically. Einstein proved, hey, like our Einstein robot here, he proved that anything that has mass, anything, you and me, will make a gravity well in space-time. Earth warps space and keeps the moon going around us. The Sun's gravity warps space so much, we are trapped in what we call an orbit. Thank goodness we were born with some awesome speed. The Earth zips around the Sun at almost 20 miles per second. Despite it being a bit one-sided, the Sun is a steady partner. Its power is inconceivably awesome. Every second, the Sun converts 600 million tons of hydrogen into 596 tons of helium. The missing 4 million tons is converted to energy. This process is called nuclear fusion. Einstein discovered it as E equals mc squared. But the Sun has only so much hydrogen, and when it runs out, it will start fusing helium into carbon. These conversions are even more powerful. The Sun will slowly expand over millions of years. It will swell into a red giant star, engulfing and incinerating Mercury, Venus, and the Earth. No worries though, this won't happen until 5 billion years from now. So we're good. Good. By that time anyway, hopefully, we might be living in a galaxy far, far away. Ah, the magnificent aurora. We can thank the Sun for this breathtaking sight. When there's a solar flare aimed at the Earth, speedy charged particles will slam into us in a day or two. Thank goodness we live on a big magnet, though. Our magnetic field deflects most of these particles from the Sun, but some spiral in at the poles and bombard our upper atmosphere, creating the Northern Lights. Obviously, all of us here on planet Earth are a bit needy when it comes to the Sun. We sure need its heat and light to survive. It may all be a bit lopsided. I mean, the Sun surely could get along without us. Call it the ultimate dependent relationship.